How is your tolerance? Did you know that a frog can regulate its body's temperature in such a way that even when it's incredibly hot or it's below 30 on the coldest winter days, they regulate their body's temperature for the environment around them and adapt in order to survive? So, there was an experiment carried out where they placed a frog into a pot of tepid or room temperature water on a device that tracks heat, because they wanted to see at what temperature the frog will jump out. Now, the frog never jumped out, okay? It stayed there and kept building its tolerance until it was boiled to death. RIP, Mr. Frog, you didn't deserve to go out that way. Anyways, what is your tolerance level like when it comes to adapting? Have you ever heard of the saying that goes like this, adapt or die? If not, well, you're welcome. Now, why am I telling you about frogs and a random quote you probably never heard of until today? Because if you haven't been living under a rock and have gone through 2020, then recent times have shown us that more than ever, we need to adapt or we will die. I mean this in both the figurative and literal sense. Figuratively, if you aren't able to adapt to life's changes, then you will be similar to a caveman trying to walk on these hot asphalt roads with your bare feet. Because shoes are a foreign concept, and it's just how you have always done things. There isn't anything wrong with that, is there? Actually, there is. Because now, more than ever, even though you aren't savvy with new things that you know deep down inside you will need, well, you just have signed your death certificate for not just you, but if you have a business, for your business as well. The Bible says, "My people perish for their lack of knowledge." Old habits can harm you and possibly kill you. There were a lot of people who said they didn't want to go virtual with their businesses, and even though they knew they were living in a technological age, they refused to adapt and transcend to a new level of life. But after COVID-19 hit, those who refused to adapt back then were plunged into a scary and uncertain time. Basically, a different way of living. Those who made it a point of duty to learn and grow are who I considered the Noah of today. Let me explain. These people knew that technology will one day take over the world. And for better or worse, they adapted and found new ways of bringing in revenue. Basically virtual revenue, which didn't just set them apart from the rest of their competitors, but propelled them into a new level of professionalism, which they can now rave about to future customers, and because of this, their new customers will see that they are a force to be reckoned with, and not even a pandemic will stop them from receiving the service they have grown to love and live with. Now to the literal part of this. Your ability to adapt is the determining factor of life and death for not just you, like I said, but for your business. There's a lot of entrepreneurs nowadays, and if you do not adapt into a better way of business, well, basically, like I said, you have signed your death certificate for you and your business. Those who didn't believe in Noah died when the earth was flooded. In 2020's pandemic, millions of businesses closed their doors and so many people lost their way of life. They basically got swept away with the current of 2020's pandemic. People who sold houses were now mowing lawns. Physical trainers were now forced to stay at home and either work for someone else or start an online business. Now, these businesses that they start online, most of them always wanted to start, but were too scared to take the plunge. Make no mistake, the Lord has so many ways of making you do what you're always destined to do. But because of the shortcuts that you've taken, let's blame it on laziness or lack of motivation or whatever you've been saying to yourself over these years. Most of you are in jobs you know deep down inside is not where you're supposed to be. You're not basically reaching your full potential, which is a result of your free will. Now, the Father doesn't send disasters, but He uses what is meant for harm and turns them into opportunities. But your perspective and ability to adapt determines everything. I know you've tried to take the easy way out of doing what you're always meant to do. Trust me, I've been there, I have totally done that. And I've eventually ended up doing exactly what the Lord wanted me to do anyways. Now, all of this landed you into this situation, and you're now searching for answers, which is why you landed on this video. The Father will use your shortcuts, but not in the way that you wanted. Just like a GPS, He will reroute you so that, you know, you're able to get to your destination quicker. Now, let me ask you this little question one more time. How is your tolerance for adapting? If it wasn't high before, my hope is that you will start training your tolerance level for many more changes to come. Listen to your gut, man. If it's telling you that it's time for you to move on and take a chance and do that thing, whatever it is that God's wanted you to do all along, do it. You have one life. It's better to say that you tried than live with regrets. All right, thank you guys so much for listening. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and smash that bell notification button so you can get more videos from me. All right, see you guys in the next one. Later.